The Karmapa's activities in India are manifold. Since 1996, for example, he has regularly visited Bodh Gaya, the most important historic site of Buddhism located in the north of India. It was here that the Buddha achieved enlightenment more than 2,500 years ago. Today, this place of pilgrimage is visited by a large number of devotees from all over the world. A traditional welcome was prepared for the Karmapa's first visits to Bodh Gaya. In 1996, the Karmapa received the basic Buddhist vows given to him by the Shamarpa at this sacred site. Over the years, the Karmapa has attended several large-scale religious gatherings, the so-called Kagyu Moonlams here in Bodh Gaya. Kagyu Lamas, thousands of monks and nuns, as well as lay practitioners from all over the world, perform the practice of aspiration prayers and of praises to the Buddha. Since 2007, the Karmapa has also given teachings at Bodh Gaya. On this occasion, he explained the meaning of a sutra, a teaching once taught by the Buddha himself. It concerns the aspirations of a bodhisattva and the way of life aimed at benefiting oneself and others. His seat was set up right below the Bodhi tree, the core symbol for the state of a Buddha.
The unsurpassable types of offerings are the supramundane ones. Through the power of concentration, one manifests an infinite abundance of offerings.
We may inspire each other, we may benefit one another through this great journey until we reach enlightenment.
In Tibetan Buddhism, such large gatherings of aspiration prayers are often concluded with an extensive offering ritual, which also includes the presentation of offering songs. Finally, as an expression of joy over this wonderful gathering, auspicious silk scarves were thrown towards the Bodhi tree. Since the 20th century, there's been a growing number of Indians who have embraced the Buddhist way of life. Buddhist conferences and gatherings take place throughout the country. The Karmapa has been invited to such events since 2005. In 2006, the 50-year anniversary in commemoration of Dr. Ambedkar's activities, who had been instrumental in reviving Buddhism in India, was celebrated in Mumbai. The Karmapa was invited to be the chief guest at this large event, and about 60,000 Indians attended the ceremony in order to take refuge in the Buddha, the Dharma and the Sangha.
M-O. overwhelmed and deeply touched by your presence here, by a couple of audience. One of the principal teachings of Lord Buddha is the cultivation of compassion for all sentient beings. Therefore, I would like to suggest the spreading of Buddhist education in India and abroad is extremely important for achieving more peace and prosperity. That Buddhism can serve not only in India, but the whole world. Dhanyavaad, namaste.
Dhanyavaad, namaste.
Me, Bauda Dhammaja Viruddha,
Prior to this historic event, the Karmapa had already attended several Buddhist conferences in India. In April 2005, he was invited to be the chief guest of honor at the first international Buddhist conference in Mumbai. Prominent Indian statesmen also attended the conference.
Friends, Ambedkar not only took care of our present, wanted us to follow Buddha, who will be even more relevant in future than he was in his own day, than he is in our time. Thank you, friends.
Everyone wants peace in this world, and it can be achieved through cultivating compassion and absolute knowledge of emptiness.
At the end of the conference, a peace march took place from the conference hall to the memorial site of Dr. Ambedkar. It was led by the Karmapa. Holding a lamp in his hand and with thousands of people following, he proceeded several miles through the streets of Mumbai. In the temple dedicated to Dr. Ambedkar, Karmapa joined the Theravada monk's prayers for peace in this world. In 2005, another similar conference took place in Bhopal.
I'm always ready to support any activity aimed at promoting the Buddha Dharma. Anyway, thank you.
Receiving the Karmapa's direct blessing is very important for the many people waiting patiently until it's their turn.
First of all, I think Buddhism is not exactly a religion, first of all. It is simply a teaching that Buddha himself taught. And so, it is simply a method to develop our minds, develop our behavior, so that one can benefit not just ourselves, but others.
This is also what motivates the Karmapa to give help to the poorest of the poor. Visiting one of the large slum quarters in India's capital, the Karmapa provides blankets and other essentials. Winter can be cold in Delhi. Thank you. In November 2005, the Karmapa was invited to Uttar Pradesh in northern India. First, he visited Agra, where the world-famous Taj Mahal stands. During his days there, he inaugurated a number of temples in Agra and its vicinity. To provide a support for religious practice, the Karmapa offered Buddha statues to these communities.
I would strongly urge and suggest all of you to generate compassion and loving kindness for all sentient beings.
In one of the villages, the square was renamed Karmapa Square, and the temple was named the Karmapa Temple.
I thank all of you from the depth of my heart. Thank you.
In keeping with tradition, he consecrated the symbols of the Buddha's presence in our world. In 2001, the Karmapa travelled to Lumbini in southern Nepal. Lumbini is another of the most important Buddhist places of pilgrimage. It is the birthplace of the Buddha. This historic site is adorned by colourful prayer flags brought by Tibetan pilgrims. Chobgye Tri Rinpoche, one of the Karmapa's Vajrayana teachers, used to spend much time here in his monastery. In Lumbini, there are a number of temples tended by various Buddhist traditions. Recently, the Karmapa was invited to inaugurate the newly built Kagyu Temple. The then Minister of Culture was present, as were many other guests from different parts of the world and dignitaries of Tibetan Buddhism.
In this age of trouble, war all over the world, it is even more important that we carry forward the message of peace and tolerance. Our aim and objective is to bring about a global peace, friendship among nations, and tolerance among all of us. Therefore, it is my fervent plea that goodwill among nations and peace and prosperity in the world may prevail for the good of all beings. I offer these wishes in my prayers. Thank you very much.
For centuries now, there's been a close relationship between the Karmapas and the Buddhist country of Bhutan. Thus, at the invitation of members of the royal family, the Karmapa has already paid a few visits to Bhutan. Traveling Bhutan took longer than expected. The streets quickly filled with devotees requesting his blessing. In 1997, Chobgye Tri Rinpoche, one of the Karmapa's teachers, passed away. As he belonged to the royal family, his cremation took place in Bhutan. The Karmapa was asked to perform the religious ceremonies. He did so along with the Che Khenpo, the head of the Buddhists of Bhutan. Court protocol gives him the same rank as the king. For the cremation, in accordance with the Vajrayana teachings, Chobgye Tri Rinpoche's body was ornamented with ritual garments and placed in the mandala. After his death, his body had remained in meditation posture for one day, indicating that his Buddhist practice had borne fruit. While Bhutanese monks conducted rituals under the guidance of the Che Khenpo, Kagyu monks from Sikkim practiced